morning, everybody. Lovely to see you. And we are also welcoming those who are joining us from home as well. So we are recording this service this morning. That might be someone phoning in, I don't know. I mean, I've only just started.
It's time for us to wake up normally.
Great. Anyway, it's lovely to, I know you'll see this a bit later, but it's lovely to have you join us at home as well. So, third week of Advent. Just warning you, I'm going to be looking for somebody to light the candle in a minute. So, you know, you might want to avert your gaze in case I catch your eye. But notice here's before then. You've all done very well. You're wearing a face mask. Thank you. That is the new guidelines for us from the Church of England. Please, we'd love to have you support us back here at 6 o'clock for the carol service. There's a lot of work gone into working out how the music group can set up in here, and it'll be a lovely evening, even if we are singing with face masks on. I think it'll be a really lovely occasion, so we'd love to see as many of you as possible here at 6. Getting a thumbs up from Chris, so I must have done that okay. Fab. Right then. Any volunteers for the Advent candle? Shall I just pick somebody? Thanks, Tom. Right, where's the... I was hiding. There you go, Tom, it's just there. Right. Good. So the response this week is challenge us to change. Challenge us to change. So, O come, Emmanuel. Come, Lord Jesus. Sure. It's all right, not yet. You can light 3 candles, though.
No. Oh, right, I'm sorry.
Not 4.
No, I realize that. Where's the middle one?
I need to get some new candles. Thank you very much. We receive the light of challenge, acknowledging much that needs to change in our lives, in our attitudes, our choices, and in our world. In a world of comfort and plenty, where many go hungry, challenge us to change. Challenge us to change. With John the Baptist and all the uncomfortable voices, challenge us to change. Challenge us to change. We light a candle in the darkness. Challenge us to change. Challenge us to change. O come, Emmanuel. Come, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Tom. Well, we begin our service together with a prayer of preparation, so if you would like to join it. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. And the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us, and write all these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee. Collect for the third Sunday of Advent. O Jesus Christ, who at your first coming sent your messenger to prepare your way before you, grant that the ministers and stewards of your mysteries may likewise so prepare and make ready your way by turning the hearts of the disobedient to the wisdom of the just, that at your second coming to judge the world, we may be found an acceptable people in your sight. For you are alive and reign with the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So we come to our readings. Thank you, Ina.
The lesson is written in the third chapter of Zephaniah, beginning at the 14th verse. Sing aloud, O daughter Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall feel disaster no more. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exalt you over you with loud singing. As on a day of a festival, I will remove disaster from you so that you will not bear reproach for it. I will deal with all your oppressors at that time, and I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown in all the earth. At that time I will bring you home, at the time when I gather you, for I will make you renowned and praised among the peoples of the earth, when I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. Here endeth the lesson.
I invite you to stand for our second reading.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. John said to the crowds that came out to be baptized by him, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bear fruits worthy of repentance. Do not begin to say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our ancestor,' for I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children to Abraham. Even now the axe is lying at the roots of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire." And the crowds asked him, "What then should we do?" In reply, he said to them, "Whoever has two coats must share with anyone who has none, and whoever has food must do likewise." Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they asked him, "Teacher, what should we do?" He said to them, "Collect no more than the amount prescribed for you." Soldiers also asked him, "And we, what should we do?" He said to them, "Do not extort money from anyone by threats or false accusation, and be satisfied with your wages." As the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, "I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." So with many other exhortations, he proclaimed the good news of the people. This is the word of the Lord.
Remain standing as we declare our faith in God together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Amen. Do take a seat, and Hills is going to come and share God's word with us this morning.
Good morning. It really is such a pleasure to be with you. This school actually is quite special because professionally I've come on a number of occasions supporting the year two pupils and been down the lower corridors there and into the kitchen area where they eat and all the stalls with all the, on their career days, because I'm a careers advisor by background, as some of you know. And I can't tell you how special it is. I don't know about you, but I just sense in a place, there's such a special place this is. And with the children, the history of your own church here, it is truly a privilege. Alison and I, some of you know, as newlyweds, came to a school hall just like this with gym equipment down in Kempshott nearly 40 years ago. So this is special, and I thank you for inviting me in and having the opportunity to speak God's word. It is an enormous privilege, it really is. Not least as Emmanuel. Emmanuel is mentioned 2,000, you probably know this, 2,500 times in the Old Testament, the Hebrew Bible. In just 13 days' time from now, we will await to celebrate God actually with us. And of course, Emmanuel means God with us. So I don't know, this strange time that we're living in at the moment, it's very uncertain. And who would have thought we'd be masked up like this? But God is truly with us, and he will see us through, and he will strengthen and encourage us, and I hope that message will come over as well. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, may your word be our rule. May your spirit be our teacher. And your greater glory, our supreme concern, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As he seldom in our lectionaries do we have the same author, in this case Luke, continuing in consecutive weeks. And last week we had Kim, who set the scene perfectly on the family, the political as well as dramatic and prophetic events concerning John the Baptist. Coming on the scene, as we heard, he responded to hearing the word of God in the desert and going to all the country around the Jordan, preaching a baptism of repentance. Also quoting from Isaiah, and all mankind will see God's salvation. It's as if one of the most significant Old Testament prophets, Isaiah, and the first of the New Testament prophets, John the Baptist, almost merge to set a very different chapter, new chapter, in the life and history of Israel, which continues to impact us today as followers of Christ. I'm going to do something slightly different now. I hope you don't mind. I would like you to imagine it's actually not me talking to you this morning, but John the Baptist, the National Visiting Preacher of the Year, beginning with his old sermon and the words in the opening verse of today's gospel. Thank you, Marion. What opening words. You brood of vipers. Just imagine people in churches all over the country. Zoomers, people online. There are other media communications platforms available, by the way. Far, far and wide expecting words of wisdom from this eminent preacher. And then this strange man stands up. He has big, unkempt beard. He's wearing clothes made of camel's hair. Someone whispers they've seen his lunchbox. And horror of horrors, it is filled with honey-coated, crispy locusts. The unspoken thoughts are, who invited him? Then it gets worse. He shouts, you brood of vipers. People walk out. People leave Zoom. It's hardly the warmest of welcomes as you and I politely stay silent and metaphorically journey to the riverbank with our spiritual ancestors. We at least are blessed to have some context. As you know, John emerged in the country around the Jordan, a devout and holy man on a God-given mission with a God-given name. An angel told Zechariah what to call his child 30 years earlier. But also, he was to be a Nazarite, one set apart for God's service. He was also, people quickly recognized, a prophet. They even began to question whether he was more than a prophet. As later in verse 15 we heard, the people were waiting expectantly and were all wondering in their heart if John might possibly be the Messiah. John knew that he was called to prepare the way for someone, although at the time he didn't know who that someone was. He was called to prepare the way for someone so great that he would not be worthy to do the work of a slave, not worthy even to untie the thong of his sandals. And so surely that could only be the long-awaited Messiah. The people were tired of religious requirements put upon them by their leaders, the priests, the scribes, the Pharisees. There were so many rules and regulations. It was all right for them. They didn't have to do the heavy work. The people did the work, paid the tax, and were told what to do. Was this really the way to serve God? It was one rule for them and another for us. Life wasn't fair. But this new preacher was giving them hope. His message was a challenge, but it made sense. It rang true. But then that shout, you brood of vipers. What? Could that be me? Then the crowd realized John had seen amongst them some religious leaders, no doubt coming out to see what all the commotion was about and see who this John the Baptist was. You brood of vipers. It wasn't addressed to the people. It was for the ears of the religious leaders. We know this, we actually know this, as Jesus said the very same words in Matthew's Gospel. Matthew 12:34. But it confirmed what the people were feeling. The religious leaders did not approve what John was saying. It didn't quite fit their lifestyle. They were vipers. The people were even more convinced that this preacher was from God. But John then immediately began to speak to the crowd and address head-on their own wrongly perceived ideas about God. He exposed their attitudes and assumptions that just because they had grown up as Abraham's descendants and therefore members of the chosen race, that they were already in a right relationship with God. I wonder, is that very different for us here at Emmanuel or St. Mark's? or viewing at home, do we perhaps think because we are Anglicans or even Christians, regularly partakers of communion or attend a home group, that we're automatically right with God? I certainly know I'm not. Astonishingly, in preaching a baptism of repentance, that spiritual deep clean, and it occurred to me strangely that when we go for communion, when we were baptized, it was like that was the beginning of a spiritual deep clean. And when we go for communion, it's that time when we get completely refreshed. It's that time where we can actually call upon God. A time of COVID as well. We know all about being keeping clean, keeping everything deeply clean. And I know Alison feels this definitely in the maternity unit. Everything has to be just gone through all the time. We're very, very conscious of this. But I want this term of being deep clean, spiritually deep clean, to be something that we can feel as we too, like those early followers of John the Baptist, began to feel as they went into the River Jordan. But they were challenged. Not even the greatest spiritual privilege then known, that of being an Israelite, makes any difference. Over the centuries, the religious leaders had followed the legal route of rules and regulations as the way to follow in the footsteps of Abraham. But they had missed the truth. Abraham had not left them a lifetime membership ticket. He had given them a lifetime example. Abraham had responded to the call of God. Abraham trusted God. Abraham, like John the Baptist, pointed the way by his obedience to the call of God. They could only follow by being individually obedient to that same call. Rules were helpful, but as for a personal response to the call of God, that is essential, as it is to us today. So as I conclude, and together we prepare ourselves in this season of Advent, perhaps like our spiritual ancestors by the river, we too can sense something deeper spiritually is missing in our lives. John was opening their eyes and ears. He was preparing the way for Jesus, the good news of the living God in person. Is not this message the very same for us today? Emmanuel, Emmanuel, God with us. God is always with us. Amen.
Thank you, Hills. Come now to our time of prayer. Let us pray for the whole state of Christchurch. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also to save and defend all rulers and governors, and specially thy servant Elizabeth, our Queen, that under her we may be godly and quietly governed, and grant unto her whole council, and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and indifferently minister justice, to the correction of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and specially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. In a moment of quiet, we bring before God those on our own hearts. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. Ye that do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbours and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, Judge of all, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honour and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If anyone sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee, and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death, until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who in the night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Amen. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. To keep you in eternal life. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We give you thanks, O Lord, for these heavenly gifts. Kindle in us the fire of your Spirit, that when your Christ comes again, we may shine as lights before his face, who is alive and reigns now and forever. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. And we most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end. Amen. Glory be to God on high, and in earth peace, goodwill towards all. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory, O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy on us. Thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art the Most High in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be among you and remain with you always.